Thank you very much, Madam Chairman.
Put it just a little closer. Okay.
Thank you very much, Madam Chairman, and members of the committee. In the face of terrorist threats and insecurity in Africa, military solutions in the first instant, while important in some cases, may prove counterproductive if not implemented and addressed in the context of other measures. We must therefore consider addressing the wide range of economic, political, and social factors that fuel conflict and insecurity and take a comprehensive, holistic, long-term approach. The situation in Mali, for instance, represents a microcosm of the complex problems challenging Africa and the need to address security concerns within a wider context. There are four distinct yet interrelated crises facing Mali, which must be managed separately yet simultaneously. First, a return to civilian authority and the reaffirmation of democratic institutions will ensure a strong, united country able to address other crises. Second, a democratic government must reach out and engage in dialogue with the Tuareg people of the north, addressing their concerns. Third, Mali faces a humanitarian crisis of well over 190,000 internally displaced as well as refugees in neighboring country. And fourth, Mali and its neighbors together have a stake in confronting the challenges posed by AQIM and other splinter groups such as Ansar al-Din. These challenges cannot be addressed in isolation, but as interrelated issues. Security is fostered by the establishment of sound leadership, accountability to the people, transparent and democratic processes addressing the needs and aspirations of the population. We look to security challenges through a wide lens, and that includes the five pillars articulated by the President in Ghana in 2009. And those five are strengthening democratic institutions, fostering broad-based sustainable growth, combating disease, improving public health and education, mitigating armed conflict, and helping Africans with transnational threats. Whether it is AQIM, al-Shabaab, or Boko Haram, extremist ideology, even those masquerading in religious terms, are antithetical, illegitimate, and repulsive to the vast majority of Africans. Extremism is a violent cancer that exploits porous borders, capitalizes on human suffering, and feeds in undemocratic environments. Our engagement will be difficult but necessary and must be based on several fundamental principles. First, regional ownership. Leaders must inspire their people, and countries must own the process to address the challenges effectively. Our African partners have consistently said African security is Africa's responsibility. Second, promotion of good governance. Our security engagement cannot be separated from our long-term goals of good governance, civilian control of security forces, and respect for human rights. Extremist ideologies take advantage of political and economic vulnerabilities. They destroy lives and strengthen instability. Building credible government institutions at all levels and assisting legitimate authorities to respond to the needs of their people are vital objectives. And three and final, the development and economic opportunity. Investing in economic and social development is crucial for improving the security environment in Africa. Efforts to address insecurity are often hampered by poor infrastructure and the inability of national or local authorities to provide adequate services, educational and vocational opportunities. The road that we face will be long. It will be hard. It will be difficult. But through patience, hard work, coordination with our African partners, and promotion of democratic values, human rights, and opportunities will make a significant difference in the lives of Africans and for future generations. Thank you, Madam Chairman.